ocala.ca. Ocala.
Minutes after 9 o'clock, it is time for Veterans News Today, a very special full hour Veterans News, so be sure to be tuned in the full hour and call in if you have any questions. The number is 622-9622 now. Hank Whittier is here. Good morning, Hank.
Hey, guys. How you doing? Thanks for tuning in. And yeah, it is an hour show today. We got Dr. Knapp here with some of his staff, and I think the subject today is audiology, amongst other things, but it's a great day. Well, we're going to, unfortunately, we do as it seems to be almost every week. We do have casualties this morning, so Gary's going to go ahead and read the casualty list and then talk to you about a couple of great sponsors, okay?
Yeah, we're going to start with the firefighters. We have Fire Operations Supervisor Terry K. Sooner, who was with the Boise District Land Management in Boise, Idaho. His date of death was June 10th. We have two police officers. We have United States Marshal with the Department of Justice, Zacchaeus Toro. His end of watch was Sunday, June 14th. And again, he was with the U.S. Marshal Service. And we have Sheriff Lanson O'Connor with the Montgomery Sheriff's Office in Montgomery County, Georgia. His end of watch was Tuesday, June 16th of 2015. And unfortunately, we also have a military casualty. We have Private First Class Montoris T. Daniel, age 19, from Griffin, Georgia, who died on the 12th of June. Our thoughts and our prayers go with all these families.
You guys, anybody local you want to mention? Okay, we got one. Lloyd Dorsey passed on the ups. Yeah, Lloyd died the other day. Don's looking at me in disbelief, but long illness. Lloyd was a good guy, Vietnam vet. Sorry to lose him, but he passed away yesterday. Went to the funeral. So, all right. I think that's it, Larry. If you would, please. Okay, Larry, thank you. I guess you're going to go ahead and do those, talk about our friends who sponsor the show?
Yeah, of course. You know, we couldn't do it without WOCU Radio, who puts us on here every week. So our thanks and love to them.
Don't forget and, Larry now. You got to mention Larry every time. That's part of the contract.
Without Larry, this show wouldn't go, that's for sure. And we want to thank Joe also. As an owner of a Ford truck with over 350,000 miles on it, I am proud to announce that our local Ford dealers, and when we say the Ocala Ford dealers, we're talking about Gainesville, Leesburg, the Villages, and Bellevue. They all have a good selection. Get on down to your closest one. Of course, the main one on Pine Avenue is located right next to the Burger King at 2816 North Pine. They're a fine dealership. You can get new cars. You can get used cars. They have parts and service, great service. And if you're not interested in buying, they'll even lease you one of these great Ford vehicles. They are American-made, and they are built by Americans. So, let's support our Ford dealership. And a wonderful folks at Bob Wine's Camellia Garden and Nursery bring us Veterans News. They have for a long time. They're located at 2610 Southeast 38th Street in our own beautiful Ocala. When it comes to your landscaping needs, they got it. Whether it's small plants or trees, fertilizers, mulch, they have it all. If they don't have it, you probably don't need it. They guarantee their trees, and they'll even deliver them. They've been keeping things blooming in Ocala since 1952, and they give you a 10% discount if you're a veteran. Now, Dr. Knapp, you had a good experience with Bob Wine's.
I sure did. We've been going to Bob Wine's Nursery probably every other weekend for the last 10 years, and we were out last weekend and bought a couple of orange trees from Lori and her husband. And not only do they have great prices, but they always help you as far as questions about planting your shrubs, plants, and trees. And oftentimes, we just drive back on a weekend and ask them questions. And Lori and her husband just are great as far as helping you. And we really thank them for sponsoring our show.
No, that's hadn't thought about that before. That's a good point, because you don't get that in the big box stores, you know. So, I don't know about you guys, but I'm not the greatest, gardener in the world, so I need all the help I can get. And Dr. Boshra doesn't go over there, does he?
No.
Because I would think, given his track record, patience, and plants, I don't think it'd be a good idea. But maybe they could help him. I don't know. Hey, listen, we're going to go ahead and get into, they have a lot to discuss. He's got three of his brightest staff here today. At least they told me that anyway. So, okay, I'm going to let you guys take over, and we'll be talking audiology. And if you've got questions, call in for sure.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Audiology is a very common complaint. We have lots of our veterans who need hearing aids, have problems with their hearing, and we brought today Dr. Mark Kalecki and Dr. Cheryl Love, who are audiologists, and Larry Barnett, our audiology technician, and I put a plug in for them. They've done a wonderful job, and their access as far as getting in to see an audiologist is just a couple of weeks, and it's the best access in Florida and Georgia. So they've just done a great job, and the patients are extremely happy with their service. So we're going to ask them a few questions to talk about their department. Dr. Kalecki, tell us a little bit about the audiology department over there at Ocala West.
Right now we have three audiologists full-time and two full-time technicians that we are running every single day. So from 7 o'clock in the morning till about 4:30 in the afternoon, we've got patients coming in and out. And we see quite a volume of patients. We do hearing tests, we fit hearing aids, and then we have people come back for follow-up. Hearing aids do require a fair amount of follow-up, and we're there for the patients to get in if they have any problems, to have their hearing aids cleaned or repaired or any other issues that might pop up.
Very good. I should have mentioned also that this year the VA is planning on expanding their space. So when you go to the clinic, that whole building we expect to have renovated in the next 12 months. So that will really help. Dr. Love, what types of hearing aids do we offer in the clinic? Are there different types?
There are. So we offer 8 different manufacturers of hearing aids. And the beauty of the VA is that we only dispense top of the line hearing aids. So you're getting something retail that would sell for $6,000 for a pair, and we're able to offer those to our vets. So we can go from teeny tiny in the ear all the way to behind the ear, but really any configuration of hearing aid that's out there, we dispense them within the VA, except for the cosmetic implantable hearing aids.
Great. Did we ever come to a conclusion, do we know what the veterans' copay is for hearing aids?
50?
Yeah, there. If you do have a copay with the VA, it's a $50 copay to have your ears tested. and another $50 copay to pick up and have the hearing aids fit to your ears. So said and done, $100 for a $6,000 pair of hearing aids.
That's great. Hank, I don't know if you know this, but even Medicare does not pay for hearing aids. So if you have Medicare, because my father-in-law needed hearing aids, it was $5,000, and Medicare will not pay, insurances won't pay. And if a veteran who has a copay, it's $100 for that. It's incredible.
It's one of the best bargains the VA offers, really, yeah. Particularly if you for copay.
Doctor, we need to take a little break, and yes, we'll be right back. Remember, the phone lines are open if you want to call the show. The number is 622-9622. We'll be right back with Veterans News after this.
Hi, Matt Wilkerson here, your mobile Verizon rep. But not just here, I'll deliver the phone to you in your home. While I'm there, I'll only sell you what you need, and I'll personalize it to you. Want to have me get you connected? Then call me at 352-528-0020. I even offer unlimited home phone service for just $20 per month. Just call me, your mobile Verizon rep, at 352-528-0020.
So you need a credit card, but how do you choose? Let's compare the big banks to Florida Credit Union. They have rewards, and we do too. They have customer service. Hello, 24/7. They have celebrities. Hey, Danny. But with Florida Credit Union, there's no annual fee, no liability for fraudulent charges, and no 22% interest rates. Choose Florida Credit Union, and you'll not only have a great credit card, but you'll have the support and personal touch that the big banks, well, can't touch. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Federally insured by the NCUA.
Want to learn more about your furnace or air conditioner? Tune in this Saturday for free tips and expert advice on how to get the most out of your heating and air conditioning system. Or get a free AC rejuvenation by being the first person to go to cleanmyac.com. That's cleanmyac.com. Saturday, free tips and expert advice on how to get the most out of your heating and air conditioning system. Or get a free AC rejuvenation by being the first person to go to cleanmyac.com. That's cleanmyac.com.
Hey guys and girls, it's Father's Day this week, so remember old dad with a green and growing gift from Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens in Ocala. The timing is great because Bob's fabulous truckload tree sale is still going strong. Hundreds of trees, dozens of varieties, a huge array of sizes, all in one place at prices that will truly amaze you. This week, you can get a large number 5 size red maple or loquat, usually $39.99 for just $19.99. Bigger trees, a number 10 size Drake Elm, one of Ocala's favorites, usually $129.99 for only $79.99. Check this week's ad for more super savings at Bob Wines, including lots of BOGO items like a special selection of crepe myrtle, hybrid tea, and even climbing roses, and yes, fruit trees too. The place? Bob Wines Camellia Garden, Southeast 38th Street, Ocala. Open daily till 4, Saturdays till 2. Homegrown, locally owned since 1952.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. It'll be partly sunny today and hot with a thunderstorm around, mainly during the afternoon and evening hours, the high 92 to 96. Partly cloudy overnight, low 73 to 77. For tomorrow, times of clouds and sun with a thunderstorm or two around, mainly during the afternoon and evening hours, the high 91 to 95. Saturday, sunshine mixing with clouds with an afternoon thunderstorm in spots, the high 91 to 95. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
All right, 18 minutes after 9 o'clock, 82 degrees here at the source. Let's return to Veterans News with Hank Whittier. Hank?
Go ahead and take over.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. Let's move along. Dr. Kalecki, tell us a little bit about causes of typical hearing loss in adults. Are there reversible causes? And it seems to me that it's only my men patients that have hearing loss.
Well, there's certainly in the veteran demographic, you're going to see just a lot more men with hearing loss because of the noise exposure that they've experienced. But it does affect, you know, both men and women with aging. As far as the reversible hearing loss, it's fairly uncommon, at least with what we see. We mostly see hearing loss due to aging, hearing loss due to noise exposure, which affects the nerve itself. And with the nerve, there's no way for us to go in there with any kind of surgery or any kind of pill and regenerate the hair cells or regenerate the nerve. Hearing aids are really, as of right now, our best approach. When you are tested for your hearing, if we see something that's a concern, like a problem with the eardrum or a problem with the bones of the middle ear that could require some kind of surgery or reconstruction, there's a possibility that that hearing can return. But the vast majority of our patients have a permanent nerve deafness that only hearing aids can help to aid and not cure their hearing loss.
Okay, very good. Dr. Love, do individuals with different severity of hearing loss require different hearing aids? If you're really deaf, do you get a different type of hearing aid?
Absolutely. So the size of the hearing aid, the smaller it is, the less power it is. The bigger it is, the more power it is. So more hearing loss usually equals a larger hearing aid. Now they're making something that they call a receiver-in-the-ear hearing aid, where you've got a behind-the-ear hearing aid that usually isn't that large, and the speaker is built into the part that goes down in the ear. So we have more room to put a bigger speaker, so we can fit truly any severity of hearing loss with that style of hearing aid, and it's more cosmetically appealing.
And how often now, what is the rule as far as getting new hearing aids?
Every 4 years.
Every 4 years,
what
okay.
We're doing.
Very good. That's important information for our patients.
Yes.
Okay, well, I'm going to move on to Larry, Larry Barnett. And Larry has a terrific program for our veterans. A large percent of people that get hearing aids just can't get them working. And Larry has a program where he brings back patients and works with them. Can you tell us a little bit about that, Larry?
Well, we have a class on Wednesday, and you can sign up or call in, and we'll get you scheduled. And we will show you the different things about hearing aids, how to maintain them, how to clean them, any type of issues or problems you're having, we go over them. If it's a fit problem, we can go over different ways to make them fit right. And we also can do a one-on-one if a patient needs it, and sometimes they do. And we bring them in and just talk to them how to maintain or how to wear the hearing aids and what they need to do. And we encourage them to bring their family members. It's always better if the spouse comes with them. It's just they both work together and learn about the hearing loss and the hearing aids.
Do they make an appointment or do they come in on Wednesdays?
No, they can call and get an appointment. And with a technician, you can usually call, get a same day appointment or next day, worst case scenario. But we can get you in pretty quick if you need to come in.
That's great. I was mentioning that in the statistic I heard was 50% of people who get hearing aids in this country don't wear them. And apparently in the VA, it's much, much better than that. And I bet it's better because the classes that we have and classes that you have to bring the veterans back in, especially when they're spouses. What experience do you have with the spouses? Are they helpful?
Actually, the majority of my phone calls are from the spouses. The spouse will call in and says, my husband needs to come in. But I do enjoy having them in. And then they get a better understanding of what's going on with the patient when he is wearing the hearing aids. There's a misconception that just because they got hearing aids, they can hear. So it's really helpful to have the family members come in and then go over the different things that we have to go over.
Very good. We have a phone call.
If you can put the headset on and just make sure you can hear me, because then you'll know that you'll be able to hear the caller. Can everybody hear me?
Yep, we sure can.
Okay. Good morning. Thank you for calling. You're on the air.
Good morning. I have a question. Does shingles affect the ears or hearing?
A very good question, because we see shingles a lot in the clinic. Dr. Klecki?
Shingles can certainly affect the hearing. That doesn't necessarily mean that if you have shingles, you're going to have hearing loss. But we have seen patients before that have had instances of shingles that have resulted in some degree of hearing loss. Yes.
Very good. Thank you for the question. I'll put a plug in for the clinic. As you know, Hank, we give free vaccinations, and we've had a program in the last 2 years where we are vaccinating all our veterans who need a shingles vaccine with shingles vaccines. And I suspect we've given out 3,000 to 4,000 free shingles vaccines in the last 2 years.
Yeah, I've got it myself for that matter. And I urge if you're over a certain age, I think you have to be over, 25?
Yeah,
which I qualify for. barely. You should get it, really, because I haven't had it, but people tell me who have it's something you don't want to get. Can I ask a question about, you mentioned, are the majority of patients coming to you from the VA, is it age-related, or is it because they've been exposed to gunfire and explosions and that sort of thing?
It is extremely difficult to pin down exactly where hearing loss comes from. Unless you have an audiogram, a hearing test, right before an incident and right after an incident. However, with the amount of noise exposure that someone receives in the service, it's significantly higher than someone who's not in the service. You're around firing practices regularly. Many of our veterans are combat veterans who are in situations where hearing protection just isn't an option. So we have to factor in that we are dealing with a high noise environment when you're dealing with veterans. So it's really very difficult to say, yes, it's 100% noise exposure or it's aging. But even without a veteran population, when you look in the private sector, there is many people who are reporting that they have a significant amount of hearing loss from the aging process itself. And a lot of people don't realize it's not so much that you're getting old as you're just getting older. You know, you can actually start to lose your hearing as early as 40, 45 years of age just from the aging process. That seems kind of young for something like that to kick in, but depending on the person's genetics, it can happen.
Were both of you in private business or private practice before you came to the VA?
I worked with Monroe Hospital locally.
Out of curiosity, do you see a lot of young people because of their exposure to, you know, very loud music? Is that,
sure.
Is that something you saw?
I actually worked with pediatrics for 7 years, and so we would see headsets, kids that wore a lot of headsets for video games, things like that, or children hunting in this area. There's a lot of hunting, but 12-year-olds with actual noise notches in their hearing, so it can start even that young. Absolutely.
Very good.
Okay. Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah, I was just curious.
Yeah. As you approach 45, you may notice your hearing is going, Hank. Dr. Lovkin, can you tell us what a typical evaluation for hearing loss is in our clinic, and describe what the booth is and how long it takes?
Absolutely. So what we do prior to testing is we do a thorough case history. We go over, you know, any sort of medical issues you've had with your ears or things that might impact your ears, noise history, all of that. Then we'll take a peek in the ears, make sure everything looks clear, make sure there's no wax or middle ear problem, and then we put you in a big sound booth that looks kind of like a freezer. And we check the middle ear system, make sure it's healthy, and then we'll put the headphones on. We do speech discrimination testing to see your ability to discriminate speech sounds, and then the pure tone testing, which are the beeps that everyone thinks of when we do that. And your results are available immediately. We go over what the hearing loss is and then what's the best option for improving your communication.
Is hearing loss like cataracts, where you can have cataracts but not require surgery yet? Can you have hearing loss and not require hearing aids yet?
Absolutely. There can be, you know, a mild loss or even maybe some early changes in the inner ear where you're just not at that point where the benefit would be there. So absolutely.
Okay. And I'm sure we get those individuals back on a regular basis. And if you didn't qualify today, you may qualify in another year or so.
Absolutely. Usually we like to see them within 2 years.
Oh, I see. Very good. Well, excellent. Larry, let me move on to a couple of common problems here. What about earwax? Earwax drives us crazy in the clinic because everybody seems to have earwax.
Yes, sir, they do.
How do you clean out ears? Is there any way for the patients to veterans to prevent earwax?
Well, I recommend, or we recommend, sweet oil or mineral oil, and they put drops in their ear, and you put it in one and then put it in the other, and then take a shower and let the soap and water run into your ear, or you can use a bulb syringe like they use for children to flush out your ears. And if that can't get it all out, there is over-the-counter medication they can purchase. It's a couple dollars at any of the local pharmacies for wax removal. And we can flush their ears for them if necessary. And we have several patients that come in every 3 to 6 months, and we flush their ears for them to keep them nice and clean.
Let me ask you for my information so I can tell my patients. So how many days in a row would you use the mineral oil that you'd put in the ears?
Well, if we're having them come in to flush them, we tell them 3 to 5 days prior. Okay. We have them use it at least once or twice a day, and then we come in and flush it out. The mineral oil actually softens the wax, so that when we flush it, it comes right out.
Okay, very good. And so they flush out ears, and actually at the Cascades we do as well. One of the things I've learned from audiology, Hank, is when my patients come in with hearing aids, I'm supposed to check the ears, because if you have an ear full of wax, you're certainly not going to be able to hear with your hearing aids. Mm-hmm. So, Larry, let me ask you then, so how do the veterans, if they have hearing aids, how are they supposed to take care of those and clean wax if they have wax in it and take care of the hearing aids?
Well, I go over that with them in the class. Depending on the type of hearing aid they have, some of them have filters on it and they can be changed. And we recommend they change it like once a month, but more frequently for some. And then with and with other patients, we always recommend they brush it off with a little brush, and we give them the equipment to do it. Right. If they clean the filters and the domes and brush them off, they usually stay pretty clean. And you can wipe them off with a little handy wipe type thing. That's what I clean them with in the clinic.
Okay. Doctor, I think we have a question.
Just hold on. We don't have a question, but we have to take a break. Okay. Sorry. My hand signals. We'll be right back. We've got about another half hour. If you do want to call in, though, the number is 622-622-9622. If you want to call in, we'll be right back with another half hour of Veterans News. This is The Source.
This is a Fox News alert. I'm Lillian
Lowe. No one in this community will ever forget this night.
Charleston Police Chief Greg Mullen, after a shooting at a historic black church, which he says left 6 females and 3 males dead, the gunman remains on the loose.
Police are still trying to figure out what the motive was, why this gunman would sit down in the church, attend services for nearly an hour before opening fire, killing 9 people. But more importantly, immediately their priority is to get this guy off the streets before he harms anyone else.
Fox's Jonathan Sarri in Charleston. Police have released photos from surveillance video of a suspect and a possible getaway vehicle.
The gunman is believed to be a white male in his early 20s, somewhere between 20 and 25 years old, sandy blonde hair, clean shaven.
The FBI and other federal agencies are helping in the investigation. This is a Fox News alert.
And now another golf confessional brought to you by Golfsmith. Recently, a man decided to spare his family the expense of Father's Day. No lunches, cards, or gifts. Then he heard about amazing savings on the latest products at Golfsmith and immediately changed his mind. Besides, he could always be thrifty on another holiday, like Valentine's Day. Hurry in for savings on prior generation Titleist Pro V1s and FootJoy DNA golf shoes this Father's Day. Only at Golfsmith. Anything for golf.
At Choice Hotels, we know business trips start with a choice. Stay or go. You can press send or press palms. Start a chat room or chat in an actual room. Just remember, opportunities won't come to you. You got to get out there to get things done.
Should I stay or should I go?
ChoiceHotels.com makes it fast and easy to find a range of Choice Hotels like Comfort Inn and Suites. So stay with us for business and book now at ChoiceHotels.com. You always have a choice.
Have you noticed the crepe myrtle are in bloom all over this great town of Ocala? If you don't have your crepe myrtle, then get on over to Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, the absolute headquarters for these local beauties. Bob Wine's has them in every color you can imagine and every size. They're all blooming or about to bloom. He even has a special selection of crepe myrtles that are BOGOs. Buy one, get one free. Come check them out and all the other outstanding specials for this week of Father's Day. Truckload tree sale, too, with savings of 33% to 66% on hundreds of trees in stock. You name the tree, you name the size, and you can practically name the price. Only at Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens in Ocala. Come pick yours out today, and Bob will gladly plant it for you. Check this week's ad for a complete list of all the savings. It's this week at Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, Southeast 38th Street, Ocala. Homegrown, locally owned since 1952.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Fidgeting can make it easier to lose weight. Many couples think that once they're married, all their issues with in-laws will disappear. But Steinhardt says a marriage magnifies these problems. So if you're having family clashes with potential in-laws, it's best to resolve those issues before you get married. Just like couples can take out a loan for a house or a new car, there's been a huge surge in loan companies catering to wannabe parents.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Your weekends are getting a little retooled.
Swear to God, not making a joke.
Check this out.
New shows?
Check.
We are Buzzworks! Some new talent?
check.
Let's welcome the guys.
Let's get it going.
Arnie Spanier.
Unbelievable.
TJ Reeves.
This is what you get.
Your weekends are on fire.
Because that's how exotic it is.
We are Five Forks.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
All right, 25 minutes before 10 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. We've got a full hour of Veterans News that we are at the halfway point, so we'll be right now going back to Hank Whittier and Dr. Mark Knapp from the VA clinic. And Hank and Doctor, we do have a caller on the line. So
let's take that and then I'll get into that.
Thank you very much.
All right, and if you guys put your headsets on, we'll be able to get to the caller.
Okay, thank you for calling in.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning. I have a grandson who swims in the pool. He complains with his ears a lot. How can I prevent swimmer's ear, and how do I treat it?
Oh, good question. Thank you. Dr. Love?
Absolutely. So the biggest thing is you want to make sure that you're rinsing those ears. You can do a half vinegar, half white vinegar, half alcohol mix and rinse his ears after swimming. If you're in a swimming pool, you're usually safer because that water's treated. Lakes and rivers and things like that are a little more concerning. But if he's complaining of pain, take him to the doctor. Let them take a peek in those ears. The only way to really know something's going on is to look in the ear.
Great. Tell us again what preventative therapy we should use.
So just half white vinegar and half alcohol, and you can just rinse the ears with that.
Okay, rubbing alcohol, not the good stuff.
Doctor, have another phone call?
Oh, we do. Okay. Good. Thank you for calling in.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Yes, good morning, everybody. See, I was unfortunate. I couldn't listen to the first part of the program. I was busy. Did you cover anything about ringing in the ear and what causes that, and is that a curable situation?
Oh, that's a very good question. That's coming up, but we're going to address it right now. So we'll ask Dr. Kolecki about tinnitus and what we do for that.
Absolutely. Tinnitus, or some people pronounce it tinnitus, it's tomato, tomato. Tinnitus is any perception that somebody has of ringing, buzzing, chirping, popping, clicking, humming, you name it, we've heard it all. If you have any perception in your ears of sound that other people don't hear, it would be considered tinnitus. It is very often a symptom of hearing loss, but it can exist without hearing loss. I actually have tinnitus myself constantly in my left ear. It's been there for a while, probably from too many concerts when I was younger. But it really isn't too much of an alarming thing. It's one of those things where if you Google it on the internet, you're dead. You know, oh my goodness, it's every problem you can imagine. But the truth is that about 20-25% of veterans experience tinnitus, and even in the general population, it's just shy of 20%. So there's a lot of people that have this sound in their ears, and it's not something to get too worked up about.
Right. Listen, we were talking earlier about you're giving out a lot of great information and a lot of great services. But again, veterans, you have to be enrolled into the system. And I think if you could spend just a moment or two about that, because you're going to get phone calls of folks who think they're just going to walk in and kind of go through that whole procedure, if you could.
Yeah, Dr. Kolecki, you want to take that?
Yeah, absolutely. In order to receive hearing aids from the VA, you have to be a veteran and you have to be enrolled in the system, which means you have a primary care doctor. And you know, you can simply go to the Cascades and get yourself enrolled in the system, and then once you're in there, you just talk to your primary care and say, I think I have a hearing loss and I'd like to be seen, and they will get you in. You don't have to serve overseas, you don't have to be a combat veteran, you don't even have to have hearing loss that's due to your time in service. It just has to be hearing loss, and that's all it takes. So it's about as easily qualified as possible.
And Hank, we have I've been in the system 11 years again this time, and we have veterans that come in only for hearing aids. and they don't want medicines from the VA. They have their own doctors. They want to be referred over for hearing aids, and there's no issue with that whatsoever. And as far as getting into primary care, our waiting list used to be 14 days or less, and we had one provider become ill. We're scheduling towards the end of June, and it's already June 18th or 19th. So we do have permission to hire a 10th provider, probably about October, November, and our waiting list for new patients will probably be down less than 14 days, probably a world's record in the VA system. So,
yeah, you know, I'm going to tell you, but I, you know, I was at Congressman Yoho's meeting a few weeks ago, and actually, this clinic and your staff and yourself were kind of used as a model. And I think that's what the VA can do when they have the right people in place. So, you know, pat yourselves on the back, and if you don't, we will, because it is an exceptionally good clinic and well-run and people who care. So this is something that even the VA has taken a look at about how this clinic is operating, and it is a model.
Well, thank you very much, Hank. We're going to write that down. Okay.
Well, do that, and it is, I think it's 20 minutes of 10, so...
We the clinic has taken just to sidelight a lot of hits in the past 10 years for access, and we've really worked on access tremendously. And as you know, we do one community event per week minimum, and the very first thing we do when we go out to a community event is ask the veterans who are in the room, are you getting into the clinic? When you call your doctor, can you be seen? If you need hearing aids, can you get an appointment? If you need mental health? So we really want feedback from the community, and if we're not doing something that we should, we're going to do a better job.
Well, and you know, not to take away from the audiology, but that's what these other programs are about. That's, we're advocates on behalf of veterans. So, you know, the reason that clinic and the VA and sometimes gets criticism is they deserve it.
Yes.
But when you do a good job and when you do something above and beyond, you should get recognition for that too. And that's why I'm kind of bragging on you today.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Okay, well, let's. We have a few more questions that I want to ask, and let's try to get those in. Dr. Love, I've had a couple patients that have really perplexed me in the last 90 days. They've had acute ear infections and pretty severe hearing loss. Do you get prolonged hearing loss when you get an ear infection? Does that get any better?
Absolutely. So with middle ear infections, there's some serious risk. You can end up with untreated ear infections that can cause erosion of middle ear bones. You can get, with chronic ear infections, fatty tumors that can grow there, holes in the eardrums, all sorts of things. So those have to be medically managed, and a lot of times we end up having to send them to see an ear, nose, and throat physician. They're beyond our scope of practice and even sometimes, obviously, primary care. But absolutely, it can cause permanent problems.
Tell us a little bit about what tumor can you get in your ear.
Okay, something called a cholesteatoma. So it's like a little fatty growth that can grow on the eardrum, and if it's not treated, it can erode the bones. It can create some pretty serious problems within that middle ear space. So it's something we would send you to the ear, nose, and throat physician for.
Can we get? I know you talked about alcohol and white vinegar. But preventative sort of stuff, I mean, so, you know, I don't know if such a thing as good ear care for the average citizen, what they can be doing, what they should avoid doing.
Sure.
I mean, I would assume you talk, you know, keep the Q-tips out of there. But if you could just talk a little bit about that.
Well, I think the big thing people confuse is there's two sorts of ear infections. There's an external ear infection, which is within the ear canal, so in front of that eardrum, things from having impacted wax, from having swimmer's ear, something like that. And then there's middle ear infections, which are actually behind the drum. And middle ear infections usually involve more than just the ear, because it's related to maybe cold and congestion, sinus issues, allergies, all of that impacts the middle ear space. So if you have sinus and allergy issues, they need to be managed, because those going unmanaged can create fluid buildup and then subsequent infection. And then not using Q-tips, not using paper clips and bobby pins and all the sorts of things I hear about people putting in their ears.
And we just got the VA every month releases new medications, and I'm preparing a talk for the RITS in 2 weeks, and one of the things is on new medications. And I don't know if any veterans listening, the old nasal steroids or nasal sprays we had seemed to be pretty antiquated, and they had a lot of side effects. Just last week, the VA released fluticasone nasal spray for individuals that have sinusitis, allergic rhinitis, and it's an outstanding nasal spray. So we switch right over. So
prescription,
you get it. If you have no copayment, it's free. If you have a copayment, it's $9.
What about the over-the-counter, you know, the over for earaches and things like that? Are there good products out there for those sort of things? Are there not so much? Is better off with the home remedies?
I mean, you need to see your physician. If you're having pain, if you're having fever and things like that, there's better pharmaceutical quality items that can be treating those issues. Over the counter, sometimes we don't really understand the effects of them as a lay person treating an ear infection at home, and sometimes you're picking the wrong thing, so you're better off to see your doctor.
Doctor, we have to take a break, and we have got another 15 minutes left in the show, and there is a call waiting on hold, so when we come back from the break, we'll go to the call.
After
this
the
is
call
the source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. It'll be partly sunny today and hot with a thunderstorm around, mainly during the afternoon and evening hours, the high 92 to 96. Partly cloudy overnight, low 73 to 77. For tomorrow, times of clouds and sun with a thunderstorm or two around, mainly during the afternoon and evening hours, the high 91 to 95. Saturday, sunshine mixing with clouds with an afternoon thunderstorm in spots, the high 91 to 95. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
The Coke Zero 400. It's where American pride meets NASCAR history. This year, you can catch a glimpse of NASCAR history yet to come with the all-new seats and all-new views of Daytona Rising. And be sure to stick around for one of the Southeast's largest fireworks shows after the race. Kids 12 and under are $10 for the Coke Zero 400, powered by Coca-Cola, Sunday night, July 5th. New seats are selling fast. Guarantee yours now at 1-800-PIT-SHOP or DaytonaInternationalSpeedway.com.
If you're anything like I was, the thought of getting older was the last thing on your mind. But here we are. For me, it started slowly. The lack of energy. Never being in the mood. And when I was, I could never perform at my best. I tried the pills and other treatments with minimal results, and all but given up on my sex life. Then, I found the doctors at New Mayo Medical Center. Wow! They made a new male out of me. Feel like I'm 25 again. I have renewed vigor, so much more energy, and no longer worry about my performance. New Mayo treated me like my situation was one of a kind. With a custom treatment plan that really works, I feel great. They can create one for you too. It does not matter if you suffer from low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, or just want to last longer. New Mayo will help you.
Call New Mayo Medical Center today at 352-404-4779. 352-404-4779. That's 352-404-4779. It will change your life. 352-404-4779.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source, 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Cookies, 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 cookies.
When you want something special and fun for any occasion, get cookies. That's right. The Great American Cookie Company in the Paddock Mall, Ocala, will make a delicious, fun-filled delight just for you. You might notice that I said fun and delicious more than once. That's because I can't say it enough. The next time you're at the mall, be sure and stop by or call 352-237-2557 to place your order.
Cookies, cookies,
yum.
Cookies, cookies. We go cookie eating cookies.
The Great American Cookie Company.
12 minutes before 10 o'clock. Thank you for tuning into The Source. 85 degrees, by the way, here at the studios. And Dr. Mark, it looks like Hank left the room, huh? Where's Hank? Dr. Mark Knapp is here. And Dr., we have a phone call waiting to get on the air.
Okay, well, thank you for your question. Go ahead.
Yes, good morning. I was just calling to see what the treatment is if you have itchy ear canals.
Very common question. All our older patients complain of itchy ears. Very common as you get older. Who wants to take that line?
I think that's a good Larry question.
Larry, go ahead.
Actually, it's the same treatment that Dr. Love spoke with earlier in reference to the half and half for isopropyl or rubbing alcohol and white vinegar. Just mix the two together and then put them in the ears, and then that should dry it out or should help with the itching ears. And if the ears get stinging or a little burning, you can cut down on the isopropyl alcohol.
Okay, well, thank you very much. I think we wanted to clarify during our break that, again, Dr. Love had talked about medication for to prevent swimmer's ears. And if you have a severe swimmer ear, the child should go to the doctor. And Larry just talked about medication to prevent earwax and to treat itchy ears. But any acute infections, we recommend that that the individual go right to the doctor. There's two burning questions I have because I'm going to get older and have hearing aids one of these days. So let me ask Larry. Larry, what do you do when someone can't use their hearing aids or moves on to another world and the loved one has hearing aids? Are those hearing aids any good? Should they be brought in back? Can somebody else use those?
They certainly can, and that does occur quite a bit. Patients will call in, and someone may have passed or they no longer use them and they want to bring them back. And depending on the age of the hearing aid, we can certainly take them and then recycle them for the veteran that maybe lost theirs or the dog ate it and the warranty's no longer available on it. We can then give them a loaner to hold them over until they're eligible for their purchase of their new ones. And even the older ones, we can send them into Denver and they can take some parts out of those. They'll take them apart and reuse them. So we can do that for them.
If the hearing aids are relatively new, can you reprogram the hearing aids for another veteran?
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Yeah, okay. We can take them and we can reprogram to the hearing loss of the veteran, and they can wear them and use them, and they function just great.
So what do you do? Dog eating your hearing aids is not an uncommon complaint. So what does the VA do if your hearing aids are a year or two old and your dog ate one? How do we handle that in the VA?
Actually, there's a really good warranty for the VA, or the veterans that are getting hearing aids. And is it a 2 or 3 year?
3 year.
It's a 3 year warranty on it. Once you've lost your hearing aid or your hearing aid has been damaged, they'll repair it for free one time per ear. So they just bring it to me, whether it's been chewed up. And sometimes we can fix it in the clinic, depending how bad it is and what parts we have available to fix them. So
that's great. I had no idea. So if you damage your hearing aid, or you can just bring it to the clinic, and within 3 years you can get a new hearing aid.
Brand new one.
Oh, that's a wonderful service. That's
great. If somebody dies and you get the hearing aids, where do we bring them if we have to bring them back?
If you can call the clinic, and I'll make arrangements to take them from you or meet you at the front and bring them right over here around the corner, Ocala West. We're over here by the Paddock Mall,
okay.
And we can take care of that. And people bring in batteries, they bring in the hearing aids, and we can recycle those and let another veteran use them.
That's great.
Yeah, I got a whole box of them in my drawer.
be happy to take them.
Battery.
Well, a gentleman asked me about the cost of the batteries. The VA does provide all the accessories with your hearing aids. They provide the batteries. They're free of charge. The filters, the domes, anything necessary, the dehumidifiers, we provide all of that free of charge. And they can call the clinic. I can give them the telephone number, and they just call in, or they can send a little card. But the easiest way is to call into Denver, and they send a six-month supply of batteries to your house. And just touching on that real quick, I wanted to mention, for the ones that may be listening that have already purchased hearing aids and think you may be eligible and you haven't signed up with the VA, you can still sign up. You can come in. We can still supply batteries for yourself, purchased hearing aids. We just have to register them in the system. And we can get you all the equipment, the dehumidifiers, at no cost to you if you've already purchased those hearing aids, and even repair them for you if necessary. So come on in, get signed up, and let us do what we can for you. You did what you could for us.
That's great. So hearing aids batteries are actually provided to the patients.
Yes, sir.
Could you email the providers that Denver phone number when you get back, and we'll keep it on our desk, because I had no idea up until last minute or so. That's great. That saves the veterans a lot of money. Yeah. Very good. Well, we're going to run out of time pretty soon, so I have some meaty topics to discuss. So we're going to forge ahead here. The service.
You've been bugging us around.
Well, The service provided by Audiology is just fantastic, and I know you guys do other things. Dr. Kalecki, can you tell us what you do for balance and inner ear problems?
Absolutely. Balance issues can be quite a problem. We do occasionally receive individuals who have complaints of balance as well as hearing. Currently, we have a gait and balance clinic in Gainesville that handles a lot of the balance complaints. In Ocala ourselves, we do not have the equipment to do the balance testing. So what we do is we'll do a case history, we'll get an idea of what the individual's concerns are, and then we'll usually refer onward to the Gainesville clinic to see what can be done for balance as of right now.
Can you do anything in the clinic for vertigo or anything? Is that referred up to Gainesville?
It would be referred up to Gainesville, usually either through physical therapy, which is what a lot of the gait and the balance clinic is. If you do have balance issues, a lot of the times, especially if it's positional balance problems, like when you roll out of bed, if you feel dizzy for a brief moment, or if you're tying your shoes or looking up at a shelf and you feel a brief moment of dizziness, usually by just a few minutes on an exam table, a physical therapist can help to relieve some of that, some of those balance problems. But all that would be done up in Gainesville as of right now.
Okay. Yeah, Hank, the VA has a gait and balance clinic, and about once a month I refer someone up there, and actually they'll spend 2 to 3 hours with the individual and family, really try to come up with a solution and outfit them with canes or walkers or other medications, or as Dr. Kalecki said, sometimes physical therapy could help with the vertigo and everything. Tremendous service if you're a veteran.
Well, it's an issue, with all the medications a lot of us are on, particularly blood pressure medication. They all say may cause dizziness
and the ringing in the ears.
And the ringing.
Tinnitus is almost always a symptom on the pills. Not that it will happen, but that it could happen.
Well, that's very good. That's one of my questions coming up. I'll ask Dr. Love, are some of the common medications that the veterans are taking affect their hearing?
So there are certainly medications out there that can be toxic to the inner ear. They're generally not something that you're going to take in pill form. They are certain chemotherapies that you might be treated with for cancer. There are my brain just
steroids,
yeah. Antibiotics, but usually they're going to be high level IV sort of antibiotics that you're going to be treated with.
How about vitamin supplements? You know, a lot of us are taking different sort of supplements. Are any of them particularly a problem for ears?
Maybe in exceptionally large quantities.
You'd have to take a lot.
A fun fact, aspirin is actually ototoxic, but you'd have to consume like a wheelbarrow of aspirin for it to affect the ears. So in the normal doses that it's prescribed, aspirin is totally friendly and fine, although it is found to be an ototoxic drug. Ototoxic meaning dangerous to the ears. But any vitamins or anything like that, I haven't seen any research.
Conversely, there are some now for the guys and, you know, supposed to be help eye health. Are there any vitamins that one should take for ear issues?
Not that I'm aware of, no.
I heard vitamin E one time.
Yeah. But, you'll hear a lot of stuff, especially for ringing in the ears, right. And that's actually something worth bringing up. If you flip to the back of any magazine whatsoever, you're going to find someone trying to sell you a $30 a pill or a $30 drop that you put in your ears to get rid of ringing, and none of it at all is approved by the FDA. None of it is backed up by double-blind scientific studies. It's snake oil, essentially. And I mean, for someone who's bothered by ringing in the ears, I understand, hey, it's only $30, it's worth a shot. But the truth is, check with your doctor before you take it and realize that it's not backed by science. It really isn't. So you want to be cautious before you take in anything like that for ringing in the ears or otherwise.
Yeah, because there is a commercial about an over-the-counter product for ringing in the ears. Yeah. You don't recommend.
I called him and talked to him on the phone. It was pretty funny. I asked him what kind of white papers backed it up, and they said, well, we don't have any. I said, well, how do you know your product works? And they said, well, a lot of people go buy it again. And I said, oh, okay, well, there you go.
That's really interesting. Vitamin E, actually, in the old days, we used vitamin E for everything, heart disease, to prevent cancer. And actually, a couple years ago, the federal government did a big study and actually showed it didn't work for heart disease. And actually, in one of the studies, it actually increased the incidence of prostate cancer, unfortunately. So we really have cut back on the use of vitamin E.
Okay. 2 minutes ago. Okay.
Well, let me ask one final question here. And can systemic diseases like diabetes or hypertension affect hearing, or is that unrelated to hearing loss?
No, I wouldn't say it's unrelated, but there's a lot of studies that still need to happen before we can pin it down. We do know that diabetes can affect hearing loss to some degree. To what degree, we don't know. But if you are diabetic, chances are it wouldn't be a bad idea to get your ears tested. You know, it's the data isn't out there right now to link the two, where it says if you're diabetic, you're going to have hearing loss. But it's certainly worth investigating anyways.
And how frequently should we be referring our veterans back for hearing exams? Every 2 years?
About every 2 years. It takes a long time for hearing loss to progress. It is a slow problem. And that's why it takes so many people a long time to get in to see us, because they notice the problem, but from day to day, they don't notice a change. And then all of a sudden, after 3 or 4 years, they start to say, okay, it's changed enough where I need to do something about it. So I would say I wouldn't go more than 2 years without getting your ears tested once you are established as an individual who has hearing loss.
Okay. Very good. Well, listen, it was a great show. You guys did very well for the first time on. You did excellent. So I'd like to get you back because it's a popular topic and it's something a lot of veterans, quite frankly, talk about and concerned about. So
I learned a lot.
Yeah. So hopefully you can come on back.
Sure.
I want to remind you, we were brought to you by Bob Wines and Ford and, of course, WOCA and my cousin Larry. Hey, Larry. Anyway,
great
show.
And get your crepe myrtles, too.
That's right.
Yeah.
Good time.
Sure.
All right. Listen, thanks, guys. You know, as I tell you every week, appreciate your service, and God bless America, everybody.
God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
This is a Fox News alert. I'm Lillian Wu. A deadly shooting at a prayer service in South Carolina. The gunman spending time among his victims before the killings at the historic Black Church.
He actually sat in on the service for nearly an hour before he got up and opened fire on the congregation, killing.